one-minute comic monologue, and I certainly didn't have time to learn one. So I wrote one, and I ended up using it for the next 30 years. I'm still using it. Mary Beth, you are not going to believe this. First of all, let me remind you that I have read every book there is to read on the subject, from Don't Talk to Redheaded Men on the Subway to 697 Quick and Easy Steps to Self-Defense. Anyway, it's the whole thing. I'm sitting in this little New York cafe, red and white check tablecloth, fresh flowers in a vase, violin music wafting it, and this man walks by. And in doing so, just kind of brushes the cuff of my sleeve. No big deal, right? Well, where he touched my sleeve, my arm starts to tingle, and it moves across into my other arm, and I am dying to see what he looks like. So I take the menu, I hold it up to my face, I just kind of sneak my eyeballs over into the corners of their sockets. That guy, three hairs on the top of his head, 300, 350 pounds, 5'1". And ever since that day, I have been madly in love with him. But you gotta have more than a monologue. You gotta have shtick. You gotta have something different. I land.